All right, well, our next guests are TV stars who've made a career out of decorating other people's homes. Now they're here to decorate our little show in fabulous. Please welcome designer power couple Colin McAllister and Justin Ryan to Studio 10.
Good morning.
Oh, you smell so good.
Oh, it's pure air of Scotland. Distilled for the lovely audience this morning. Morning, everybody.
Oh, what a lovely couple to have on the couch. Now,
welcome.
Aussies will know you from your many, many TV shows. How did you fall into this?
It's an interesting thing. We've worked in property flipping in Britain for many, many years. And at the same time as buying up really bad rundown properties and then fixing them, we were celebrity homes editors with a magazine called Living, etc. in Britain. And the magazine career and the flipping career just began to fuse. And we moved into daytime craft-type television. And then we had a punch-through show with the BBC, moved to Canada, and now we're kind of getting our tendrils into Oz.
I like the lumberjack outfits, by the way. I think they're really going to take off. It's a dream job for a lot of people, just to you know, just to have that taste and be able to just tell people what looks good. How do you get into something like that?
You know, I think if we were filling in our kind of passport application, it would say full-time enthusiasts. And I think that's what we do. You know, I think it's up to us to, you know, go to all the gift fairs, all the kind of fashion fairs around the world, but then try and dilute that so that actually the ordinary home, the normal person out there, gets it. And I think that's our mission. You know, we're always looking to make the ordinary homes extraordinary.
Yeah, and that's been our push. You've got that certain pizzazz that does that. I mean, the rest of us sort of think, oh, I don't know.
Come on, look at, we can spot the style princesses. Look at you.
I'm speaking on behalf of the viewers. Look, what are you doing in Australia?
Okay, we're here for many things at the moment. We're here, we're presenting seminars at the Reed Gift Fair this weekend and also the Life in Style exhibition. And they're really a celebration for the retail industry of complete and utter excellence. It's all about, for us, speaking at those seminars, we're going to tell people how to apply design principles to their shop floor and therefore sell more, because at the end of the day, we're all in business to stay in business, so that's what we're doing. But we're also, we actually appeared on the British version of I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here.
Yeah.
And it, well, there we are here. I was in tears because Colin got voted out. I'm not at all prone to drama. Colin was bullied. That's not,
not
a good
at
look.
All.
I don't know which is more terrifying, the colour of my hair or the non-stop tears. That this show is a monolith in Britain, and we're excited to be in Australia as it grows in popularity over here. And we were down and deep in the jungle in a state of abject terror and famine.
Why were you crying before?
Well, Colin had been voted out before me because I proved eminently more popular with the public.
Yeah, I'm afraid I had to tear myself out of the jungle and go and suffer in the 7-star Palazzo Versace in the Gold Coast. So sad, people. You know, see, when you're watching this show, honestly, it's so truthful, it's so lifelike. I lost 18 pounds in 18 days. I couldn't stay any longer. I was just disappearing.
Is that what it is? Is that why you were crying? You were tired and hungry?
Fatigued, completely fatigued.
Because he was imagining Colin in the 7-star Palazzo.
But it's incredible. Your mind plays such bizarre games on you. There's Colin parachuting into the jungle there. Your mind plays such bizarre games and the famine takes over. It's bonkers. Did you enjoy the jump, Colin?
That's 12,000 feet. I had to jump 12,000 feet to actually get there. It's outrageous, honestly. It's like a form of television torture. But it's great fun.
Six-pack.
Did you see that six-pack?
Bring it out.
Oh, I tell you. And then I did a swimwear shoot on the Gold Coast beach after that. I thought, I'll never be this skinny again. Give me those trunks, people.
Now, you guys, just back to your renovation and design, I'm actually house hunting at the moment.
Okay.
So I'm obsessed with this sort
of stuff.
Think
twice, buy once. Don't buy your first thing. Really take your time. You've got to be completely aware of what you want. Don't be tempted by what people tell you you need, and always look at the ripple effect.
Yeah.
Okay, the next neighbourhood is a tube stop away, a train stop away.
We want to show the audience some of your amazing before and afters.
Okay. I'm pretty sure that's before.
Well, that isn't either before.
Exactly. Before and after.
Oh.
Oh, wow.
We take chicken poo and we create delicious chicken pie. Really? I mean,
he's got such a great eye.
Yeah, but, I mean, see, that's just a normal suburban home, you know, and that's the basement.
It's colour, isn't it?
Yeah, it is colour, but it's also about presence, you know, and it's about trying to problem solve. So we look at families and we think, okay, what rooms do you actually need?
Wow. And what we're also doing in Australia at the moment, we're doing some segments for The Living Room. And we worked with Channel 10 in The Living Room and WTFN, the production company, to find Australia's daggiest homes. Yeah. And we found some absolute shock. Well, do you know what? We have been overwhelmed by how terrifying some of the properties here are.
How daggy they really
are.
Yeah.
And we found a wonderful one in a place called Hoppers Crossing in Melbourne. And we did a home in Parramatta. Two of the worst homes that we've ever seen. But by Jove, I think we've created some absolute wonder. Wow. We love what we do.
And if you can tell. And just before you go, you've got a very nifty little DIY project or trick.
Well, apparently we do, yes. You know what, we're trying to put the smile into style. We're always saying that kind of like having a stylish home is not about spending money, it's about spending time. And if you actually look at that there, you know, get your old trusty glue gun out. And it's about pimping up things that you actually have already, you know. So these were kind of like dollar store vases, and we just added a bit of texture to them, you know.
To bring them to life. I mean, that's what we find already in Australia.
Look, the door opens.
Voila!
That's what we love. We don't have to spend a lot of money. I mean, we've already been, you know, getting a feel for the landscape. Even stores like Target have got brilliant retail selections, really good homewares. It's really developed. And this particular project is just craft store goodies, some raffia mats, a little bit of rope, and imagination. And as Colin and I always say, the one thing that doesn't cost anything is imagination.
That's very true. Or as I like to say, if you can glue it, do it.
Yes, if you can glue it, do it. Get through it.
Colin and Justin, thank you so much for being on our show. Colin and Justin are in Australia for Reed Gift Fair's huge design and lifestyle event in Sydney this weekend. The details are on your screen now. We'll put them on our Facebook page as well. Thanks, boys.
Our pleasure.